Hi everyone. So today's video tells us that since the government has been changing a lot of laws, a lot of formats, so we need to keep ourselves updated, and we cannot just learn it once and think that okay, this is the format that I'm going to follow. So a lot of videos on the YouTube are basically that this is the final format, but I feel that the format is actually evolving. So if you see the website today, the GSTR-1 format has been changed. On my left, that is on the left part of the screen, you see this. This is what Tally had given the GSTR-1 format earlier. However, if you see the website, the format has changed and the current format is on the right side. So what I've done is, you see that it's the same company. The company is the same, and I'm seeing it in a previous version of Tally where the format set by the government was different, and now the format set by the government is this. And very efficiently, Tally has also brought in that same format. So the number of vouchers, in fact, the data is absolutely same. However, you see there is a difference in the way formats are represented, because that is what the government demands. So this is the old one and this is the new one. Again, let me say, this is the old one, not required anymore. This is the new one. Okay. Now, because this is the new one, we'll only consider this. And here, what we can probably do is we'll take a look at what are the things, how this is getting populated, and the way you were making entries. But the forms will be populated automatically in Tally like this. Okay. Yeah, so this is a taxable sale. Okay, so this is a simple sale entry that has been made. So we'll come here, we'll press enter, we'll say what the sale is about. It's simply a sale to a registered party. And okay, since it's the same state, CGST, SGST applies. We'll come back, and similarly, we'll see a B2C small invoice where the invoice is being done from Odisha to say West Bengal. Therefore, IGST is applicable. Okay. And you might wonder why it is showing in B2C small invoices. So what B2C small invoice here, if it is an unregistered party, okay, that is B2C, the C part is because of being unregistered or a consumer. Only if it is an IGST sale, there is also a provision that only for IGST sales, we have to show it like this. Okay, in separately in this form. Now, there's one more thing that has been added. The vouchers here will be visible state wise. Okay, so you will be able to view it state wise. Yeah. So you will have the list of states here, and you'll be able to view it like that. Okay, so yeah. So again, nil rated. Similarly, you'll have nil rated, and I have say interstate sales to unregistered person. He is an unregistered party in Bengal, and interstate sales has been made to him. Okay, and while you're making an entry, I have selected. I'll show you what have I done here. When I'm making an entry like this, it asks me for what is the classification nature. So here I'll write nil rated interstate sales. That's it. Then it will not give us an error. Okay. And we'll come back. We'll see the other entry that I have made. So it is local sales to unregistered persons. So because it's a local sale, it could be cash as well. Take it as sales, and we'll again classify it as sales nil rated, and simply press enter. That's how this is getting populated. Okay. Other things are also similar. So local sales to a registered person and all that can be, will automatically come here. But while you're making an entry, you'll have to select this. This part should come. I'll tell you which one. Yeah. This classification has to be selected correctly. So when you come here, you just press the spacebar key and you will get a list of all these transactions. Whatever nature of transaction you select, that will be taken for up for that transaction. Okay, so I'll keep it as nil rated sales. Okay, so That's it.